temperate zone, which is mainly herbaceous plants like Spartina alternifera or cordgrass. There's only about 70 mangrove species worldwide, and that's out of 20-something thousand tree species. So it's a really rare evolutionary trick to be able to live in salt water. The trade-off is you're not very resistant to freezing. There are no temperate mangrove species. But as climate's been changing, you're seeing fewer and fewer cold snaps in areas that used to have, you know, 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 cold snaps per year that would knock their growth back and reduce survival. Now in areas like St. Augustine, it might not freeze once every 10 years or so there. And that's a big enough window to allow these mangroves to get into those areas, start producing baby mangroves like these here, and start moving up the coastline in response to reduced number of cold snaps with climate change. So mangroves are really important wetland foundation species. That is, this particular species or set of species forms the entire ecosystem there. It's a relatively small group of species. You might find a wetland with 1 to maybe 3 different mangrove species for miles and miles up and down the shoreline. And that essentially buffers